Hello and welcome to my video. My name's Josephine and today is Back to Basic Monday. And on the last three Mondays, so this is the fourth Monday now, I've been showing you very back to basic card making and the tools that you have to use, matting and layering, toppers. Today I thought that I would share with you the tearing technique of two ways of tearing cutting paper technique and cutting your paper in half. And yeah, so I'm going to show you this, obviously, and all that is cut in half, how that works. So the tearing technique, one side and the other, because there's two ways of tearing. And plus, I thought today I would bring in some punches as well. So I've got square punch, circle punch from my stash, and I'm sure all you ladies out there have got some punches. I've brought in my butterfly punch, which I'm going to use today. I've brought in my it's a tiny little cupcake punch, which this card is a gatefold card. I've matted and layered, I've torn this paper, and I've punched out these cute little cupcakes in a corresponding, obviously, colour. And then here, I've actually, I'll show you this side, punched out to make windows with my square punch, and then punched out again some squares, with a corresponding colour, and then punched out some more cupcakes. And this is what I've come up with. So this is using, obviously, a coloured cardstock, which is a dark pink and a light pink, some gems, which we looked at last week, and two bits of paper and sentiment, and obviously a punch. So yes, so this card actually shows you every element that we're actually going to look at. So I'm going to put this to one side. And we're going to, let me put my punches up. So ladies, you know, some people find that using their punches sometimes is a lot quicker than getting your die cutting machine out. And I've got some Stampin' Up! Punches, and if anybody knows Stampin' Up!, they actually do coordinating stamps to go with the punch, and I'll be showing those to you in another episode. But yes, I thought I'd obviously do this first. So obviously I'm going to mat the spotty card onto this, and using my Collar glue just quickly, and we'll put this card together. And I will show you, because I'm going to mat this, I'm going to punch out a window. So you can pick up punches from the range. I'm not too sure whether the Works do them or Poundland, but I know that the Range do, and obviously Hobbycraft do them. Oh, my papers keep falling off the table. Yeah, sorry about my voice. I'm still trying to get over this horrible cold. In actual fact, I haven't actually had a cold as such, because I've had a flu jab, but this cough is awful. Now, I'm just going to have the basic card, 5x5. Now, I'm hoping that this punch will go straight the way through. And I'm using this punch in the top, looking at it, it's going to be, the bottom right-hand corner. So I was looking it upside down, saying the top, but yeah. And I'm going to punch through it. And it's given me a lovely little window. So I think I might do the top one. So what I'm doing, I'm making sure that it's lined up to there. And I'm going to punch. So I've got two little window. And perhaps I should do one in the middle. Now I just decided to do one. Not three, but hey ho. So, oh, that's gone off to one side. Never mind. I can live with that, though. So then what I'm going to do, and it's still got a little bit of glue, oh, that's sticking to me, is I'm going to mat this inside. So yeah, this, today's back to basics, is all about, and I do believe that goes there, does it? That'll do. That one, what about this one? Is that already done? Let's do this one. So yes, my back to basic Monday is looking at ways that you can use your backing papers without actually having dies. I'm just using tearing techniques. I'm not too happy about this, but never mind. I'm going to go with it. I should have just stuck with my first random one. Never mind. Hey ho. So you can tell how it's not straight. Oh dear, never mind. So yeah, you please will forgive me, won't you? But I just wanted to show you what you can do, obviously, with your punches. So I've got a star punch here, and I could do that as well. So that's quite a nice big one. You can buy the punches and get some cheap punches from eBay as well. So always have a look. Now, just going to put this to one side because I want to use this nice edge here, but I want to tear it. So I'm going to show you on this side here. Now, everybody likes tearing, and I know it's a good technique, and we are going to tear this bit here. Oh dear, that's terrible tearing, Josephine. Dear me, you can tell that I'm not well. Sorry, ladies. So obviously, you've got this now, the way that this paper, you can actually see the way that this paper is actually made. So this has been stuck onto white card, so that's why it's actually come off. But good paper, you can actually colour, will go through, and you will get one white bit and one, obviously, your brown. Now I wanted to tear this, and let's just show you. I'm going to do it on the other side, and hopefully it will, because this is how I want to. So quite a lot of people, when they tear their paper, they get this white edge, which is okay if you want that. But then a lot of people would like this edge here. So my advice to you is, if you are tearing a coloured card like this, and you're okay about having this white edge, that's fine. Tear it towards you. You can tear it the other way as well. So if we tear it the other way, it should. And that's the same. I am right in the first way. So yeah, there's the two ways, obviously, of having your torn paper with the white or without the white. Now, if you're like me, and I've got a design that I want to tear, which is here, I'm going to tear to me and on the back of it, so the white colour, because I don't want this white edge. I want this edge here. And I am going to put this down here. I'll just pop those away like so. And I'm just going to pop some collar glue. So I hope, ladies, that makes sense and you understand this about the tearing techniques. And I know there's loads of ladies out there. I think Amy, I've seen you use the tearing technique. But I just wanted to make sure that you all knew about the two ways of actually tearing. So you can tear towards you or back, or like I did with that one, I turned it over and then torn it towards me, and I haven't got this white edge. Again, with this white edge, if you don't like it, you can always ink it as well. But I'm quite happy with this. So I've used my punch for my window, and I've torn here, which I'm really, really happy about. Now with this, I'm going to use this punch, which is going to make me some butterflies. I'm going to punch out a few butterflies. Now, as I say, with punches, we're going to randomly perhaps put two down there and one there. Just do another one. Okay. I'm going to glue these on. I'm going to put three down there, I think, which is really cool. So have a look at your punches. You can use your punches for so much, and you don't actually have to get out your your dies. As I say, loads of people do like still using their punches. And I think, there's a lot of us ladies, we have got, I mean, I've got quite a few different ones that I'm still in love with, that I will be showing you more of the different punches in other series. But I just wanted to show how you can make a quick window card like this. And perhaps I should put, what I wanted to do was put one in there, but it's not a big enough one. I think that's quite cute. And let's bling it. As you know, I love blinging. And we're going to put, I'll use that one, a happy birthday along there. And this will be the end. Just trying to see what I'm going to see. I'm wasting time. Oh dear. So obviously I want to bling up these butterflies. So I will bling them up and bling up in the middle here. No, that doesn't look quite the right pink, but hey. And I'll pop a few other little bling on here. So this is my first card, obviously. So I've used the tearing technique, and I've used my punches. So So ladies, yeah, get out your tearing technique and use your punches and make, yeah. I mean, if you've got loads of paper or just oddments of paper, just little oddments of paper, and perhaps you've got some small punches, just punch them out, circles or whatever, and just have a random go. So that's the first card, okay, which I've done. I'm just going to pop that to one side. Ooh, where am I going to pop it? I don't need these no more. Pop those down there. So my second card, which this has fallen on the ground. Dear me. So like I say, this is a bit of like matting and layering. So this card is 5 by 7, and I've cut this paper at 4.5 by 6.5. And then I decided, and I have done this in quite a few of my different cards. Obviously, I haven't got any coloured card underneath. It's straight onto craft card. But I've decided to slant cut it. Okay. So then, and then when I'm going to put it down, I'm going to put it down so there's a gap. Now, you can slant cut more if you wanted. So this opens up like this one, or you can do it this way as well and have it like that, the tenth fold. So yeah, I've decided I'm doing this back to, yeah, I'm doing this upside down. So I'm going to have it this way, and it's a very, very quick and easy card. Look at your papers and have a look at cutting them in different ways, because sometimes if you cut them in different ways, it just gives a different, completely different dimension to your card. And you know, you can make a quick and easy card like this one, and this is very quick and easy because I just didn't want to put anything else on it, so I wanted to show you just the gap. And I've put something else, and so this is the topper, and I'm going to quickly use some foam pads and just to raise this up. So it is a bit of a, I would say, a masculine card with a bit of a twist on it, because we never know, and sometimes when you cut your paper a little bit different, yeah, it can turn out quite cool. So I'll quickly do this because I really want to get onto my next card, and I know that I never have enough time for you ladies. So yeah, that's there. And then we're going to put this on the bottom there, and glue. So I'm so pleased that everybody's loving this Back to Basics. I really thank you so much. Right, so this is quite a cute and simple card. I've got this little lighthouse, and this all was decoupage, but I'm terrible. I use my decoupage totally different from anybody else. I just try to get the most out of what I've got. And I'm just bringing in this lighthouse. So this is all about cutting your paper and making a different, yeah, just making a different look on it. So that's my second card. Done. I will bling it. Right, my third card, I've decided to do some tearing, and I've already sorted something out. So as you can see, I haven't got the white edge because the white edge is here. I've done this, I have, again, I've torn this on the back. So I'm doing a side stepper card, okay? So I want to put this there, but I want to put this underneath. And I want to tear it, so which will be there. So again, I'm tearing it to me, and I'm, hold on a minute. Should have torn it this way. Yeah, sorry, I'm tearing it away from me. And again, this paper. Oh dear me. I think it's just the paper. Right, which one shall I have? Do you know what? I'm not happy with this. I am going to tear it towards me. There. I'm happy with that. So I want that to sit there and that to sit over it. Okay, so I'll put this one down first. So yes, so have a look at your papers. There are some excuse me, my voice. There are some rulers, special rulers out that you can tear along. I think they're called tearing rulers, and they're the different shapes and things, and they are quite good because then you get this edge instead of the white edge. And it's okay if you like the white edge, that's fine, but yeah, in some of your projects it's good to have the white edge, but I just wanted to show you without the white edge and obviously what it looks like. So that's there. I'm going to put this green in here. And I'm going to make sure that the writing is up the right way. All different ways. There. Okay, so I've torn the paper. Now I quite like that. And then I quite like this. So I'm thinking of, again, tearing towards me. Very carefully. So now that one has got